We've been rehearsing this music at our separate schools, and today is the first time that we rehearse together as a group. We hope you enjoy our first piece, which is called Doppler Effect.
The term Doppler effect is defined as the shift in frequency of acoustic or electromagnetic radiation emitted by a source moving relative to an observer as perceived by the observer. Yes, it is when the siren comes at you at one pitch and leaves you at another.
John O'Loughlin was inspired by this effect and created this piece, which provided us with the opportunity to focus on dynamics, musicality, and articulation. We hope you enjoy Doppler Effect.
Called Shalom Shamarim. It is based on an Israeli folk song that has been passed down through many generations. The text is a traditional Hebrew blessing, the English translation of which is,
"Farewell, dear friends. Stay safe, dear friends. Have peace, have peace. We'll see you again. We'll see you again. Have peace, have peace." Of the melody and builds in intensity to a complex four-part round. As a final farewell stated, the music fades away to a soft conclusion.
I'd just like to thank all the students for their hard work. It's been a pleasure working with them during this event. I'd also like to thank everyone for the support in Reading. And now Daisy's going to announce our next piece.
Our next piece is Highlights from the Star Wars Saga, arranged by Paul Cook. This medley includes the Imperial March, also known as the Darth Vader theme, Cantina Band, Han Solo and the Princess, and the Star Wars main theme. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
to a performance like this with such a large appreciative audience. I know on behalf of Mr. Norton and myself, we really appreciate all the support that all these kids get being in music. It's not always easy to fit it in. There's a lot of stuff going on. But as you can see, they sound awesome, and it's such an important part of that. There's a lot of our membership that does both band and chorus. So we're going to take just a really short transition while the chorus kids file out of the band and join the chorus for the second half of our concert tonight.
Arts Fest is when the entire town, K through 12, comes together to celebrate the arts and student achievement in the arts, which is, the arts, of course, to me, are very important. And one of the coolest things is that we have the middle schools join together, and they play and rehearse for maybe just an hour a piece in the afternoon, and then they perform 200 plus kids on stage together. And the choruses do the same thing. The elementary school does that. And it's a way for us to join together and make music. And the other piece to Arts Fest is that we have the visual arts. Mm-hmm. And as those people who came to see it saw the beautiful art gallery of work, K through 12, and it's sculptures and 2D and 3D and a lot of art. And I think it's just the two nights to celebrate what we do all year long and what we do. It's like, like in the world, art and music are so important. And it's a way for us to show what we do in the school to help celebrate that.
Thank you. traditional Zulu folk song from South Africa.
The Swahili text of Aya Ngena means there is strength in unity.
In this piece, we'll be singing a four-part harmony as we stack up three separate choral parts and a desk camp.
Our performance will include several special elements: body percussion, soloists, and guest percussionists from the Coolidge and Parker bands.
The guest performers from Coolidge will be Sierra Belizos, Eva Bonzi, Katie Delaney, Renee Haley, Jason Capodistrias, Maddie Lamone, Liv Parziali, and Antonio Cerrone. They are joined by four percussionists from Coolidge: Julia Johnston Lynch, James McTaggart, Matt Nickerson, and Ben Rodstein.
And then the small group members from Parker are Sarah Bocci, Nicole Boyer, Ava Coelho, Abe Daguerre, Adam Diemer, Lauren Donovan, Marla Driscoll, and Hannah Shapiro. While we have our percussionists, Luke Backer, Lucas Martin, Niles O'Connor, and Christopher Sewell. We know you're going to enjoy Aya Ngena.
Musicians. I'm so proud of the way that both the chorus and the band performed tonight. please, if you can, stay with us for our 6:30 performances, which will feature the high school and middle school jazz bands. And while you're here, please take a moment to look at the wonderful work that is displayed out on Main Street. And a special thank you to our district art teachers who really did a fantastic job with that. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you again, and please enjoy your evening.
This is the second night, and Arts Fest, every year, we, the 10 music educators, get together and we will be talking and debriefing and seeing how it went well, what we can fix. And I think this year we finally have it. And one of the challenges is how do you get all the kids on stage, off stage, the audiences in, audiences out, without being aggravated. Because the first couple years we didn't quite have it down. And you had hundreds and hundreds of people trying to move. And everyone was crabby. And that is the opposite of what we want them, the experience we want them to leave with is they've just heard this beautiful music that their kids are making and seeing the beautiful artwork, and then you make them not find parking spots and all that kind of stuff. So this year we think we finally have it down where people can come in, find parking, find a seat. You know, we have smooth transitions so that by the time 6:30 comes, the next concert's ready to go and nobody has to wait for anything.
Good evening, thank you all for coming tonight. Our first piece tonight is called Angel. It's a West Montgomery piece. It's going to be featuring Miles Warner on tenor sax and Luke Hollenbeck on piano.
Thank you.
you know, one of the things we tried to do originally was show the early singers and all the way up to the high school so you could see it transition, but that didn't work out with the audience and how big the groups were and stuff. So we're not able to do that with the choral and with the band, but with the jazz band you get to see that. And, you know, like the middle school teachers, each middle school teacher conducts, so the kids from Parker get to see the conductor from the other school and vice versa. And then with the elementary, the three elementary teachers who are running the choral, they get to each conduct pieces. And, you know, the problem with the high school groups, like I conducted my own groups last night, and Mr. Mulligan conducted the symphonic band, and likewise tonight, you know, so there's nobody we can partner up with. But so what we tried to do is we came up with some lighthearted pieces that would be audience appealing. So that's what we did with our portion of it.